Phelps, Bekowsky. Beat cop says he located a green Kaiser Frazier from the hot sheet. Address is 6 West 2nd Street. Get over there and see what you can find out. Go on. Sorry to inconvenience you.
We're on it, Captain. I swear, the more bent cars we bring in, the longer the hot sheet gets.
It pays the rent, though. It keeps Mrs. Phelps in the manner to which she's accustomed.
I'm not sure she'd agree with you.
Passionate, romantic type like you, Cole? I don't believe it would.
Mouthpiece for scripts off me at the grand jury. Case got thrown out. Now the DA wants my head.
They're calling her the Dahlia now. Wonder what Veronica Lake makes of that one.
You hear whether they're making any progress?
Captain Donnelly seems to think they have it all wrapped up. Brown and Green are sweating this manly character. I heard it'll be in front of a grand jury by next week.
Poor thing. Terrible enough being murdered like that without having an event. Spoon all over the front view.
Enough to answer questions.
1247, Detective Phelps, requesting immediate backup in pursuit of a stolen green Kaiser Frazier from 6 West 2nd Street.
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out. His wheel arches. Come on.
Oh, hey. Maybe I was a couple miles over the speed limit.
Hands behind your head.
I'll call it in.
Why did you run from us?
I saw a big car in my rearview mirror with two tough guys bearing down on me. What would you do?
What's your name?
Cliff Harrison.
You're under arrest.
For what? What are you talking about?
Nice try. I'm talking about the car being stolen.
You're out of your mind. I bought the car, and I've got the paperwork to prove it.
Looks like we'll have some questions for the people at Coombs Automotive. Do you have a criminal record, Mr. Harrison?
No, nothing like that.
You expect us to believe you?
Is that so much to ask?
You purchased this car from Coombs Automotive Company?
Yeah, that's right.
And the ownership papers?
From the same place.
If this is a forgery, it's top notch. This will need to be traced. Who did you deal with at Coombs Automotive?
The owner, Richard Coombs.
And he made out the bill of sale personally?
Of course he did. He kept a facsimile for his records. Check with him.
We're going to get to the bottom of this, Harrison. Until we do, you're going downtown.
You gotta be kidding me! I'm getting arrested for buying a goddamn car?
If everything is legit, Harrison, you'll be out soon. Until then, if I were you, I'd keep my mouth shut.
I guess possession is evidence, and have him arraigned for Grand Theft Auto.
Right, Detective.
You know who my father is!
We need to get to Coombs Auto and check out Harrison's story.
What? I think he's telling the truth.
Some of the most convincing people you will ever listen to are born liars. Usually they're called politicians.
The paperwork all looked above board, and he seemed like a clean-cut kid.
Uh-huh. Well, I get it. You see some kid who's basically you 5 years ago and assume he's got to be innocent.
I'm more than happy to be proved wrong.
Hey, if he'd been black or Hispanic, you'd be singing a different tune. You spout all this communist crap about treating everybody the same, but it only works one way.
I'm not sure that's communism, Stefan.
Oh, God, please. Not another history lesson from a man who single-handedly won the war.
Are you finished?
Yes. I feel much better now. We'll shake down the car dealer and take it from there. Unless his daddy plays golf with yours, of course. In which case, we'll give him a firm gentleman's handshake and be on our way.
See? I knew you weren't finished.
Not another step. I have got a Buick Century sedan that would be absolutely...
Detective Phelps, LAPD, are you the owner?
That's right. Richard Coombs, at your service. You looking to trade in a black and white, boys?
Mr. Coombs, we're investigating an auto theft. A man by the name of Cliff Harrison claims he bought the car here.
Well, some people would say that my cars are a steal. That's a joke, son.
Very amusing, Mr. Coombs.
I remember Harrison. It was a green two-tone Kaiser Fraser, if I remember rightly.
Do you have the bill of sale?
It's in my office. Walk this way. That's a joke, too, son.
Phelps, you mind if I shoot this guy? He's getting on my nerves.
Here it is. Got the original pink slip there, too.
Archer, 146 North Fremont Avenue. Harrison's purchase receipt was legit, at least. We have a couple of questions.
All right, fellas. Shoot.
Can you tell us how you came to buy the car?
Girl just wandered in right off the street.
You need to give us something, Coombs, if you don't want to be implicated in this.
Yap, yap, yap. Son, your problem is that your gums keep flapping, but you do no listening.
Can you describe this Gene Archer?
Brunette, maybe 25, 26. Little on the plump side, but not bone ugly.
What was your impression of her?
Kind of harried and harassed. In a hurry to go somewhere, but no place to go. You get to know the type.
Do you know anything about the company that prints these pink slips?
Nope. Should I? It isn't exactly my business.
That's a lie, Coombs. You're printing the slips. This whole racket comes back to you.
So, I'm some kind of criminal kingpin. Son, I can't wait to see you prove it. How about you take it easy, kid? You're going about it like a sailor in a whorehouse, grabbing whatever you can reach.
This was all above board.
Yes, of course it was.
You're lying, Coombs. You knew the car was stolen.
You have some sort of crystal ball tucked in your jacket that can help you prove it? You should try rubbing some oil on that hard head of yours. Are we done here?
We get awful attentive to people who obstruct LAPD investigations.
Well, Harrison might be off the hook, but we can still run an APB on Gene Archer. Get on the horn and call it in.
Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
Requesting an APB on Gene Archer, age approximately 25, on suspicion of Grand Theft Auto.
I'll relay the information.
I need an address on a Marquee Printing Company.
Marquee Printing Company, sure. Just a moment. Aliso Street, near San Pedro.
Messages for me, please.
A James Belasco is being held at Central Station on suspicion of GTA. Possible link to the Harrison case. They're waiting on you to conduct the interview.
Thank you.
Now, national news.
Here's a chicken and egg question for you. Do you think you have to be an asshole to sell cars? Or that selling cars turns you into an asshole?
You've got it in for everyone today, haven't you?
I've always got it in for cars' sake. It doesn't matter what they want. And why do they always think they're comedians when they're about as funny as a heart attack?
Maybe the more annoying they are, the quicker you sign on the dotted line just to get the hell out of there.
Detectives, Belasco is prepped and ready in two. Another stolen car with legit paper.
Thanks.
That's the guy. I heard he's an honest cop. Well, there's an oxymoron for you. If you can fake sincerity, you got it. She wants a five-star. Goddamn right.
crummy bastard.
James Belasco?
I want a lawyer. It's my car and I got the proof right here. Take a look for yourself.
Canary says the thing, but if I guarantee he'll walk.
The paper is real enough, Belasco, but the car isn't yours. This pink slip is a forgery. Where were you taking the car, James?
Blow it off, greenhorn. You'll get nothing from me.
You were taking the car to Coombs' car yard. He gives you cash, and the car's getting new papers.
Who the fuck is Coombs? What are you talking about? Give me a lawyer. I'm tired of talking to you.
Does the name Jean Archer mean anything to you?
Nope. Never heard of her.
You're a liar, James.
Say that again. I'm telling the truth. I don't know the broad.
So that's why you both have the same address printed on your pink slips. She's a mule for these stolen vehicles, genius. Same as you.
Jesus. All right, I know her. Stupidest broad I ever met. Always cooking up crazy schemes. I don't know why those guys use her. You happy now?
You had a chance to cooperate, Belasco. See you in 10 years when you get out.
You're Phelps, right?
Yes, I am. Look, can we do this later? I'm in the middle of it.
Ray Pinker. I'm with Technical Services. The pink slips are all real.
Yes, we know that.
There's only one company that prints them in California, the Marquee Printing Company. They've confirmed that the numbers are legitimate.
You've checked them out?
Sure. They're on Aliso Street near the corner of San Pedro. The guy I spoke to was Lightball, Gordon Lightball. Here, I wrote it down.
Thanks, Ray. This is a great lead. We'll get down there as soon as we can.
Phelps, your GTA suspect, Gene Archer, spotted by a patrolman. Western Union office, 253 South Hill. Less than a minute away down the street if you run. Go! She won't hang around.
Open your eyes!
LAPD. We'll take it from here.
God damn it. Everyone's against me. Look, just let me get my money and get out of here, okay? You look sweet. How about giving a girl a break? That could be very nice.
I'm afraid I can't do that, Miss Archer. Stefan, call for black and white.
Just my luck to get the only hair sure cop in the LAPD.
The car you sold to Coombs was stolen, Miss Archer. There won't be any money.
I handed over all the right paperwork when I sold it, Buster.
Jean, you've blown open the whole operation because you were dumb enough to try to sell one of the cars. What do you think they're going to do to you? Give me something.
I was just doing what they do. They pay me $50 to drive the car. I made $2,000 selling it.
You made zero. And if they catch you, you're dead. Is that all your life's worth?
Look, a girl needs things. I don't see you looking out for me.
How long have you and Belasco been delivering cars?
Who is James Belasco?
You're lying. James Belasco. I don't remember mentioning his first name, Miss Archer.
Oh, I think you did, didn't you? Well, I'm sure of it. Anyway, I don't know him. So because you just don't like me, you can call me a liar.
You decided to make this hard on yourself, Gene. Let's see how you handle the hard time.
To getting her own way.
Little did she know her feminine charms were useless against the impenetrable Cole Phelps.
She's not my type.
And what is your type, Phelps?
I'm married.
I know that. But you're not blind or dead inside, are you? Wait, scrap that second half of the question.
I don't know. Blondes, I guess.
Hallelujah! The man is human after all. Now we're getting somewhere. Yep, I'm with you on the blondes. Brunettes are fine too. And there's nothing wrong with a good redhead. But I draw the line at gray. You know, I might have to lift that embargo soon in the interest of maintaining a free market.
A man with high standards.
The standards are only as high as the last glass of whiskey.
What can I do for you, gentlemen?
I'm a traffic detective from Central Division. Who's in charge here?
I am, Gordon Lightfall. What's this about?
We understand that your company prints California vehicle titles.
Yes, I have the government contract to print pink slips. I've done for some years.
Have you had any goods or equipment stolen recently? We're running up against stolen cars with seemingly legitimate paperwork.
Not recently. Have you ruled out forgery? There's no shortage of talented artists in this town.
We'll keep it in mind. We have some questions for you, Mr. Lightball. Do you have a delivery ledger, Mr. Lightball? We would like to cross-check against the Coombs Automotive Emporium.
It's a little out of the ordinary, Detective. I'm not sure I can share those sorts of records.
Hand it over, Lightball. You don't want us having bad thoughts about you, do you?
Very well. But this really is irregular. Over here.
Look for patterns, recurring names, unusual addresses, anything out of the ordinary.
Greeting you from Los Angeles, California. KGI Radio 760.
You certainly encourage repeat business, Lightbulb. This Mr. Bigelow is a good customer. Mr. Lightbulb, we're currently working two auto theft cases. Do you know anything about a car theft ring?
Certainly not. Why would I get mixed up in a thing like that?
I think you're in this up to your neck, Lightbulb.
You're out of your mind. What an allegation. I'll report you to your superiors. The chief of police is a very good friend of mine. A very heartfelt and genuine apology is in order from you, young man.
Do the names Cliff Harrison and James Belasco mean anything to you?
No, they do not.
Harrison bought his car from Coombs. The pink slip looks good, and that points the finger here. Do you have any employee trouble?
No, I don't. They've all been carefully screened. Look, now that I think about it, the name Coombs sounds familiar. I think they may have been involved in stolen documents in the past.
Sorry to bother you, sir. We'll let you know if there are any developments.
You Marines were gung-ho, Cole. You have a 45, don't you ever want to use it? I'll take the back. Just give me a few seconds to get around there.
Cole Phelps, LAPD. All of you are coming downtown with me. Reinforcements on the way.
Right there,
between your eyes. Throw out the... At the end, I heard something.
All right, don't shoot! Keep your hands up. Watch him, Bekowsky. He doesn't move until I've tossed this place. Key Printing Company. There's nothing like going direct to the source.
Betting slip. Looks like Mr. Lightfall has been on a losing streak.
Saying anything till I've seen a lawyer.
There are enough slips here to keep them stealing cars till Christmas. We've got a trail of pink slips and stolen cars that leads right to your door, Bigelow. You're in this up to your neck, but I don't think you're the man in charge. Make it easier on yourself. Give him up.
I do work on cars for customers. You charge in here shooting up the place like it's the Ballad of Bulge. I can't give you anything.
We know about Marquee Printing. You can make this easier on yourself by giving us your man on the inside.
I sometimes repair cars and put them back on the road. I need a pink slip to resell them.
There's no problem there.
There are at least 4 dead men in this warehouse. A couple more. Punks won't make for that much extra paperwork. We'd be doing the legal system a favor.
Okay, tough guy. I get the message. Lightfall. The guy who runs Marquee. He's the big shot. He likes to spend big at the track. He owes people.
Lightfall, the guy with no luck at the track. Tell me about him.
It's one of the guys lying over there. You're right. He has no luck.
So if I go over there and check his jacket, your story's gonna ring true? I'm warning you, Bigelow.
Give it a try, Flatfoot. For some reason, none of my guys like to bring ID to work.
Whether you give up your bosses or not, Bigelow, you're going away for as long as I can put you there.
We'll see. I didn't fire a shot, copper. I just watched you tear my place up.
You know the way. You can drive. And where exactly are we going?
What a mess.
Gonna take some cleaning up, that's for sure.
I wish it hadn't gone that way.
Well, they shouldn't bring guns to work with them. We didn't have a lot of choice.
You have to admire the barefaced cheek of someone who tries to blow your brains out one minute and pleads innocence the next.
Yeah, especially when he's surrounded by evidence. You know, guys like Bigelow spend so much time convincing themselves that they're not doing anything wrong that they actually start to believe their own bullshit.
They get sloppy. Bigelow, Lightfall, all of them. If they hadn't, who knows how long they could have kept this racket going.
Complacency or greed. It's always one of the two that brings them down.
You're under arrest.
You again? This harassment is starting to wear thin.
We found a box of pink slips in a warehouse full of hot cars. You signed for them, Lightbulb.
I signed for all the orders and deliveries. You'll need something better than that, cowboy.
Save it, Lightbulb. We already have all we need to send you down.
I've had enough of this. You either produce some shred of proof, or I call my attorney.
You're in the hole with the organization. We know about the debts, Lightball.
I agree. I have a small problem. I'm prepared to help you in any way I can, Detective. I'll name names. I need you to keep this out of the paper.
You need to shut up now, Lightball. Gordon Lightball, I'm charging you with conspiracy and fraud. Hands behind your back.
The LAPD Central Traffic Division has today smashed a nationwide auto theft ring, writes crime correspondent blah, blah, blah. Oh, here it is. Traffic squad detectives confronted a large group of armed thugs. After an exchange of gunfire, more than a dozen dead criminals were removed from the scene. The LAPD sustained no casualties. Damn fine work, Phelps. Now get out there and nail some more bad guys, will you? I want to finish reading this.